In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God, and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all.
And with your spirit.
Welcome, everyone, as we gather together on this 19th Sunday of Ordinary Time to celebrate our faith. We come together as a people of God, prepared to give honor and glory to our Heavenly Father and thanksgiving for all the graces that He gives to us. I thank you for being with us, however you have found us, coming through us, through the internet and the various electronic ways that you have come to us. I'm glad that you are with us. Today's Mass is being offered in a very special way for Father Sam Felbo, who passed away this past week on Tuesday. Father Sam was a priest that helped out here at Our Lady of Las Vegas Parish. And when I first came to Las Vegas, back in 2008, he was my first pastor, or my second pastor, really, at St. Anthony of Padua Parish. So we worked together for a couple of years. Father Sam was a very nice man. People really liked him. Little Italian man who had a very infectious personality. And he's going to be missed. And so I offer this Mass today in his intention for the repose of his soul, that he may be welcomed into the kingdom of heaven. And so as now we gather together today for the celebration of this Mass, let us do so as we always do by, first of all, acknowledging our sins before God and asking Him for pardon, mercy, and forgiveness. And may Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen. Glory to God in the highest, and on earth, peace to people of goodwill. We praise you, we bless you, we adore you, we glorify you.
Let us pray. Almighty and ever-living God, whom taught by the Holy Spirit we dare to call our Father, bring, we pray, to perfection in our hearts the spirit of adoption as your sons and daughters, that we may merit to enter into the inheritance which you have promised. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever.
Amen.
Amen.
A reading from the first book of Kings. At the mountain of God, Horeb, Elijah came to a cave where he took shelter. Then the Lord said to him, "Go outside and stand on the mountain before the Lord. The Lord will be passing by." A strong and heavy wind was rending the mountains and crushing rocks before the Lord. But the Lord was not in the wind. After the wind, there was an earthquake, but the Lord was not in the earthquake. After the earthquake, there was fire, but the Lord was not in fire. After the fire, there was a tiny whispering sound. When he heard this, Elijah hid his face in his cloak and went and stood at the entrance of the cave. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
A reading from the letter of St. Paul to the Romans. Brothers and sisters, I speak the truth in Christ, I do not lie. My conscience joins the Holy Spirit in bearing me witness that I have great sorrow and constant anguish in my heart. For I could wish that I myself were accursed and cut off from Christ for the sake of my own people, my kindred according to the flesh. They are Israelites. Theirs the adoption, the glory, the covenants, the giving of law, the worship, and the promises. Theirs the patriarchs, and from them according to the flesh is the Christ, who is over all. God bless it forever. Amen. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God. Be with you. A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Saint Matthew.
Glory to you, O Lord.
After he had fed the people, Jesus made the disciples get into a boat and precede him to the other side, while he dismissed the crowds. After doing so, he went up on the mountain by himself to pray. When it was evening, he was there alone. Meanwhile, the boat, already a few miles offshore, was being tossed about by the waves, for the wind was against it. During the fourth watch of the night, he came toward them walking on the sea. When the disciples saw him walking on the sea, they were terrified. "It is a ghost," they said, and they cried out in fear. At once Jesus spoke to them, "Take courage, it is I. Do not be afraid." Peter said to him in reply, "Lord, if it is you, command me to come to you on the water." And he said, "Come." Peter got out of the boat and began to walk on the water toward Jesus. But when he saw how strong the wind was, he became frightened, and beginning to sink, he cried out, "Lord, save me." Immediately, Jesus stretched out his hand and caught Peter and said to him, "Oh, you of little faith, why did you doubt?" After they got into the boat, the wind died down. Those who were in the boat did him homage, saying, "Truly, you are the Son of God." The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
All of Jesus' miracles are pretty spectacular. The ones that are recorded in the Gospels are there not to just show Jesus pulling magic tricks out of a bag of some kind, but to convince his followers and his disciples of who he is. And at the end of this gospel passage today, we see when Jesus got into the boat and everything quieted down, the disciples did him homage and said, "Truly, you are the Son of God." And there you go. That is what all this is about, so that we can acknowledge Jesus as being truly the Messiah sent by God, that we can acknowledge him truly as the Son of God. This is a spectacular incident where the disciples are out on a boat, and in a physical sense, they're in that boat, and the wind is blowing, and they're rocking, and they're out there. It's night. And they see this image of a person walking toward them. Well, what are they going to think? It's a ghost or something. There was something they never expected, that Jesus was going to walk out to them over the water. And they began to be terrified, as any of us probably would. But again, Jesus comes in, and as he has said so many times, in every situation in which there is all kinds of chaos going on, whether it's in our hearts, our minds, or however it is, Jesus always says, "Calm yourselves. Don't be afraid. Fear not. Be still. It is I." He comes to bring peace into our lives. The chaos that goes on, the things that turn our lives upside down, Jesus is there to calm it and to tell us to trust in him, to look at him. Because all those things that happen in our lives happen within our hearts, within our minds, all that stuff is going on. And Jesus says, "Just look at me. Look at me. Have peace, because I can bring that peace, and I do bring that peace to you." And we see that happening here and in another situation where Jesus was in the boat and they were out there, and again, there's a storm raging and the boat's tossing about, and the disciples says, "We're going to sink, we're going to die." And Jesus is kind of like asleep on a cushion, it says. So they finally wake him, and they said, "Lord, don't you care that we're going to perish here?" And Jesus kind of looks at them and says, "You have little faith." Just as he said to Peter, "Why did you doubt?" So he gets up and he says, "Peace, be still." The wind dies down, the sea calms, and again it's calm. And that all happens in a physical sense. But yet, again, we can bring that, again, to the inside of what happens inside of our soul, inside of our hearts. When so many situations in life distress us and bother us, all we have to do is turn to Jesus. Don't doubt. Just believe. Look at him.
and know that he will calm the storms of the heart. He will calm the storms of our emotions and all that bothers us. He will bring us peace. And that's what this miracle that Jesus performed, this is what mostly is all about. Not the fact that he actually did calm the sea, but that he brings peace. We see Peter wanting to walk on the water himself. Peter, you know, he always likes to challenge the situation in a lot of situations in the gospel. And so Jesus says, yeah, come on out to me. So he gets out, starts walking on that water. But he takes his eyes off Jesus for a moment and perceives the strength of the wind and the waves and probably wondering, what am I doing here walking on the water? And he goes in. And Jesus takes him by the hand, raises him up, and says, why did you doubt? Why do you take your eyes off me? Because with me, you can accomplish everything. We can accomplish everything with Jesus as well. The storms of our heart, our mind, our soul can be calmed if we just focus on him. That's what Jesus wants us to do. And that's what he asks of us to do as he performs this miracle for his apostles, his disciples, and for us as we contemplate what happened on the lake that night. Please join with me now in professing our faith. I believe in one God, the Father, the Almighty, maker of heaven and earth,
of all things
visible and invisible. I believe in one Lord Jesus Christ, the only begotten Son of God, born of the Father before all ages, God from God, light from light, true God from true God, begotten, not made, consubstantial with the Father. Through him all things were made. For us men and for our salvation, he came down from heaven, and by the Holy Spirit was incarnate of the Virgin Mary, and became man. For our sake he was crucified under Pontius Pilate. He suffered death and was buried, and rose again on the third day in accordance with the Scriptures. He ascended into heaven, and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again in glory to judge the living and the dead, and his kingdom will have no end. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord, the giver of life, who proceeds from the Father and the Son, who with the Father and the Son is adored and glorified, who has spoken through the prophets. I believe in one holy, Catholic, and apostolic church. I confess one baptism for the forgiveness of sins, and I look forward to the resurrection of the dead and the life of the world to come. Amen. Aware of God's quiet presence at work in our lives, let us now place our needs in prayer before him.
For Pope Francis, successor of Peter, may God continue to bless him with good health and vitality. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For the elected officials, may God graciously watch over them in their service to their people. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For military personnel, police, fire and rescue, and all first responders, may they be blessed and protected in their work to keep us safe. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For our parish community, may the Holy Spirit help us more firmly embrace our faith in a loving God. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For the sick of our parish family, our local community, who may feel isolated or abandoned, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For those who have died, especially Larry Tokar and Barbara Polson, may they be welcomed into the eternal life God gives through his Son. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayers.
For the repose of the soul of Father Sam Falbo, for whom this Mass is offered, and for our own private intentions, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayers. O Lord Jesus Christ, you commanded Saint Peter to come to you on the water. Even though his faith was weak, you did not let him falter. Instead, you caught him and renewed his faith. Catch us when our faith is tested, and intercede for us now and always, for you live and reign forever and ever.
Amen. Amen.
Lord,
Please pray now, my brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours will be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands for the praise and glory of his name, for the good of all his holy church.
Be pleased, O Lord, to accept the offerings of your church, for in your mercy you have given them to be offered, and by your power you transform them into the mystery of our salvation through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
And let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, through Christ Jesus our Lord. For through his paschal mystery, Jesus accomplished the marvelous deed by which he has freed us from the yoke of sin and death, summoning us to the glory of being now called a chosen race, a royal priesthood, a holy nation, a people for your own possession, to proclaim everywhere your mighty works, for you have called us out of darkness into your own wonderful light. And so, Father, with angels and archangels, with thrones and dominions, and with all the hosts and the powers of heaven, we sing the hymn of your glory as without end we now acclaim. You are indeed holy, O Lord, and all you have created rightly gives you praise. For through your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ, by the power and working of the Holy Spirit, you give life to all things and you make them holy. And you never cease to gather a people to yourself so that from the rising of the sun to its setting, a pure sacrifice may be offered to your name. Therefore, O Lord, we humbly implore you by the same Spirit, graciously make holy these gifts we offer to you for consecration, that they may become for us the body and blood of your Son and our Lord Jesus Christ, at whose command we celebrate these mysteries. For on the night that he was betrayed, Jesus himself took bread, and giving you thanks, Father, he said the blessing, he broke the bread, and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, Jesus took the chalice, and giving you thanks, Father, he said the blessing and gave the chalice to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith.
We proclaim your death, O Lord, and profess your resurrection until you come again. We proclaim your death, O Lord, and profess your resurrection until you come.
Therefore, O Lord, as we celebrate the memorial of the saving passion of your Son, his wondrous resurrection and ascension into heaven. And as we look forward to his second coming, we offer you in thanksgiving this holy and living sacrifice. Look, we pray, upon the oblation of your church, and recognizing the sacrificial victim by whose death you will to reconcile us to yourself, grant that we who are nourished by the body and blood of your Son and filled with his Holy Spirit may become one body and one spirit in Christ. May he make of us an eternal offering to you, so that we may obtain an inheritance with your elect, especially with the most blessed Virgin Mary, the Mother of God, with Saint Joseph, her beloved spouse, with your blessed apostles and glorious martyrs, with Saint Peter, and with all the saints on whose constant intercession in your presence we rely for unfailing help. May this sacrifice of our reconciliation, we pray, O Lord, advance the peace and salvation of all the world. Be pleased to confirm in faith and charity your pilgrim church on earth with your servant Francis, our Pope, and George Leo Thomas, our Bishop, the order of bishops, all the clergy, and the entire people you have gained for your own. Listen graciously to the prayers of the family that you have summoned here now before you. In your compassion, O merciful Father, gather to yourself all your children scattered throughout the world. To all our departed brothers and sisters, to Father Sam Felbo, to Larry and Barbara, and all who were pleasing to you at their passing from this life, Father, give kind admittance to your kingdom, for there we hope to enjoy forever the fullness of your glory through Christ our Lord, through whom you bestow on the world all that is good. Through him, with him, and in him, O God, almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever. Now, at our Savior's command, informed by his divine teaching, together let us pray. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil, and graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, Lord, we may always be free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
The kingdom, power, and glory are yours, now and forever.
O Lord Jesus Christ, you said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you." Lord, look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, for you live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
And may the peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
And let us offer each other a sign of peace.
Thank you.
Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world, and blessed are those called now to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed.
Thank you.
Let us pray. May the communion in your sacrament that we have consumed save us, O Lord, and confirm us in the light of your truth through Christ our Lord. Amen. Thank you, everyone, as always, for joining with us and celebrating this Mass on this 19th Sunday of Ordinary Time. I thank all of you for your participation, your prayers, and just being together, even if it is through the internet or whatever way you are with us. Thank you for being with us. I also thank our crew here, very small, with their 1, 2, 3, 4 people with me. Teresa, thank you for being the lector, and Mike for manning the cameras, and for Eva and David for providing with beautiful music, especially that communion hymn was one of my favorites, just an uplifting song, so thank you. Written by David as well, so it's very, very nice. And we thank all of you for your continued support of the parish, through online giving, through sending your checks in the mail, through calling the office with your credit cards, through bringing your donations to the door, however you get it to us, please know that it is so much appreciated, and we thank you very, very much. Also, please remember to pray for our First Communion children who are finally making their First Communion. It's backlogged from last May, which they couldn't do it, so now we're finally getting around to doing it. Also, please pray for our youngsters as they begin school very shortly, in just another week. We're going to open our doors for school this coming school year on August 17th is their very first day. So please pray that it all goes well and that they remain healthy, that we're able to provide education for our children, even in the midst of this pandemic that's going on, that everybody is healthy and we can do the best that we can. So please let that be in your prayers as well. And so if you're celebrating a birthday or anniversary or something good going on in your life, Teresa, you? Oh, when is it? The 12th. Well, happy birthday to you and to anybody else that's celebrating something special going on in your life. Yes, because we really need good things happening now to lift our spirits because, you know, a lot of people are walking around heavy-hearted with all this going on, but we need things happy to be in our lives. And if you are being heavy-hearted, that's a good way to say it, please know that our thoughts and our prayers are with you to lift you in spirit. And so, until the next time that we meet again, let's ask God to graciously bless us with his grace. The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
And may Almighty God bless you, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
This Mass is now ended. Go in peace, glorifying the Lord by your lives.
Thanks be to God.